Welcome back to TenorShare, everyone. The iOS 17 have some interesting upgrade on the FaceTime app. Now it has three different video mode effects you can use. The Studio Light effect, Portrait effect, and Reactions effect. You can find these three options in the Control Center while you are using the FaceTime app. The Studio Light mode effect could make your background darker or lighter. The Portrait mode effect can blur your background, kind of like the iPhone camera cinematic mode. You will get a great blurry effect around you. The reaction mode effect needs to trigger by different gestures or tapping them. According to Apple saying, now there are 8 kinds of reactions available, now I am going to show you how to trigger them. The first one is heart reaction. All you need to do is make a heart gesture. Then FaceTime will recognize it and pops up a lot of heart emoji around your hands, which is great for showing love to your family and friends. The second one is one thumb up reaction. Do a thumb up gesture and you can trigger it. The third one is the fireworks reaction. Do a 2 thumbs up gesture and the fireworks will pop out. This one is really good looking. The fourth one is a thumb down reaction. Do a 1 thumb down gesture and it will be triggered. The fifth one is cloud reaction. Do a 2 thumb down gesture and the rain will cover your screen. The sixth one is the balloons reaction. Do a peace sign with one hand, then those lovely balloons will come out. The seventh one is the confetti reaction. Do a peace sign with two hands, and the confetti will be pouring out from the top of the screen. The last one is laser reaction. This one is cool. Do a rock on sign with two hands and you can trigger it. Most of the reactions might not be that perfect, but still, these reactions could make the FaceTime call between family, friends, or colleagues more interesting. I think Apple will upgrade more reactions after iOS 17 is getting better. Still, what you guys need to know is, the FaceTime reactions gesture is only available on the iPhone 12 or later devices. This means if you do those gestures on iPhone 11, iPhone XS, iPhone XR or iPhone SE 2020, those reactions won't be triggered. But still, you can hold down your screen, and the reactions list will pop out. You can trigger them by tapping them one by one. If you are a user that using iPhone older than iPhone 12, and you upgrade your iPhone to iOS 17 just for the reactions gesture, then this might be letting you down. You can still go back to the iOS 16 without any data loss if you want. You can check out this video. Okay, that's it. I hope this video is helpful to you. I will post more videos about iOS 17, iPadOS 17, and macOS 17 in the future. Make sure you subscribe. See you next time.